Hello friends, so today in this video we're going to discuss the third problem from the latest AdCoder Beginner Contest 201. Problem name, secret number. The problem A and B are like they're not too difficult, you can easily solve them out. The third problem I'm making a tutorial, and the fourth problem I will also make a tutorial after this. So the problem statement is simple, yet the problem is good, and like a lot of my members are asking this. So also one of my friends is asking on the group also. So you can also join the Telegram group if you haven't. So we're gonna discuss the problem now. So Takahashi has forgotten his PIN. The PIN is a 4-digit number. Okay, so it's a 4-digit string. Now it consists of 0 and 9. Okay, and it can also begin with 0. It means that the PIN can also be 0102. Okay, like anything, like your ATM PIN, like it can be, it is consisting of four digits, and all the digits can be anything from 0 till 9. So now, for each digit 0 to 9, Takahashi remembers about the following facts. Now, actually Takahashi forgets his PIN, okay? So because he forgets his PIN, he just remembered that he has a string consisting of 10 characters. 10 characters means that every character belongs to like the particular digit. Okay, so if the ith string character is 0, it means that, or O, it means that the PIN consists of that digit. Okay, if it is X, the PIN doesn't consist of that digit. If it is a question mark, it means that he is not sure whether the PIN consists of that digit or not. Now, how many strings are possible with this given constraints of S? So I'll tell you with example. As you can see, if it is given in the example, like this sample example, as you can see, Takahashi is saying that the PIN, like let's assume that there's a 4-digit PIN. The PIN consists of 1, like 0, 1 and 2. Because these are OO, it means that the PIN should consist of 0, 1 and 2. Now he is not mentioning how much time. I will tell you with the last example, that will make you more clear. As you can see, this 0 is just telling that the PIN should definitely consist of 0 and 1 and 2. The PIN may or maybe consist of 3, 4, 5. But the PIN should not consist of all of these numbers, like 7, 8, like 6, 7, 8, 9. So the PIN should not consist of 6, 7, 8, 9 for sure. The PIN might contain like this number, which is like 3, 4, 5. And the PIN should consist of 0, 1 and 2. Now these are the conditions and you have to form the answer. Now the last example also made me one like think more clearly. As you can see in this problem, there is only 1 0 and 1 question mark. It means that the PIN or the answer can be, because there is 1 0 which is in the 9 number, it means that the PIN should consist of 9. Now it is not telling you how much time that 9 is occurring. It means that the 9 can be, the number can be all 9s. Okay, because 9 should be there. It is not mentioning how much time 9 should be there. Also it is mentioning like this digit can be there, which is like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you can see, all these digits are not there, but 5 can be there. 5 might be there. So if let's assume that 5 is there, then the other digit can be 9. Or like the 5 can be in the middle and this can be 9 9, or there are 5 2s and 9 9. Everything is possible. Okay, there is no 5, all the things are 9. Everything is possible given the constraint that there should be 9 in that number or in that PIN. I hope you get the point. Now how I actually solve this problem out, I first thought that I should do some different permutation combination type of thing. That can also be done, but like I was also thinking about some formula or like how to calculate that part, but I suddenly realized that it is a PIN of 4 size, and at every position can have like 10 digits. So I have to just check 10 to the power of 4 numbers, because this is the maximum number of pins which are all like possible. Or I hope you get the point, because every position has 10 digits which can be placed there. So I iterate over every possible like PIN position. So I write a for loop, like 4 for loops, like for loop, kender for loop, inside a for loop, again inside a for loop. Okay, for men, like, and again for loop. So this is I, J, K and L. Okay, this is actually mentioning about the each PIN digit, and each is going from 0 till 9. I hope you get the point. And that will form a PIN. Now for every PIN, I will just like check that whether this PIN is valid according to the given constraints which are given me in the form of the string S. If any of the, so as you can see, the first condition which I have to just check that all the digits which are here, and I have also mentioned that some pin digits should not be there for sure. X should not be there. So I have to first check that whether any of these digits should not be equal to X. If any of them is equal to X, that is for sure not the pin candidate. I have to find a total number of candidates now. So that can all, like, that possible pin is not the candidate. So just move on, continue out. The other case can be that, okay, that this is equal to zero. Okay, and this is also equal to zero. This is also equal to zero. But now the case which comes to my mind is, okay, if all of them can be equal to zero. My question is actually asking me to ensure that if there are three zeros, then all the three zeros should be there. I hope you get the point. So if there are, let's assume that the number which should be there, or the digit should be there, is 0, 2 and 5. So it means that in this number, in this pin, 0, 2 and 5 should present. It is not mentioning how much time. So it means that the number can be, the pin can be 0, 0, 2, 5 can also be a pin. 0, 0, 2, 5 can also be a pin. But as you can see, the other pin possible can, like, there can be number of ways or number of pins which are possible. So there are number of pins which are possible, but we have to also ensure that, like, all the three numbers should be present there, or, like, if they are 0025, all the numbers should be present. We should not care about how much time it is, like, occurring. So it means that, and if there is some question mark, then it is also valid, like, it is also valid that that question mark can be there in this pin, but I have to ensure that these numbers, or, like, these digits should be there. These digits should be there. The question mark can be there or cannot be there. It is, like, no guarantee that the question mark should be there or not. So it means that I have to find out. So what I'll do here is I just iterate over this I, J, K and L and just store them in a set. Because set store them, or, like, we have to just count out that what are the different numbers of, like, how many different numbers are there. Because if any one of them consists of X, we just neglect that pin. Now my pin only consists of those numbers or those digits which is only question mark or zeros or, like, O's. Okay, if it is O's, then I have to ensure that all the O's should be there. Like, if there are three O's in the example string, in the input string, then in this pin also there should be three O's, and the O number of O's should be such that the total number of O's, like, let's assume that the string has three O's, then the different O's in this should be also three. Okay, the three different O's should be here also. So that's what I've done, so that I can put them into set. So if this is, like, 0025, then this is actually cancelling out and becoming only 10. So I will know that, okay, there are three different digits here, and also my string also have three different digits, which is, like, 005. So it is like according to my constraints. But if the digit is, let's assume that if my sum pin can be, like, also 0002. Now also, as you can see, if for this example, the number, if I'm checking for the first digit, this is 0, which is also O, because when, like, this is valid, and this is also valid, because the number of O's in our given string is 005. So this is also valid. So this can also, like, my computer can say that this is a valid pin, but this is not, because 5 is not there. I have to ensure that all the, like, all the zeros digit, all the O's digit should be there. Okay, so because how we can check that, we just have to ensure that all should be there. So we can just find out or put them in a set, so that all the repeated ones should get out and only the single ones which are same. So if the number of, so as you can see now, the different digits are only two digits which are different, 0 and 2. So it is not matching out with the different digits which are required, which is 3, and thus that will not continue on our final answer. And we just have to ensure that. And if this condition is ensured, then, like, either if there is some question mark number also there, then we just have to, like, we can also include that. Okay, so if there is some pin which is, like, 0257, I will find out how many different O's are there. And if there is question mark, we just neglect it, because we don't care about the question mark. We just have to ensure that, because X should not be there, we have neglected X. We just have to ensure that the number of zeros should be there. So we just have to ensure that, and question mark, we just neglect that. I hope you understand the logic part now. We can move to the code part. You can link the code in the description also. That's what I've done. First, count out number of zeros and question mark. We just have to check the question marks only, like zeros only. That's what I've done. So what I have done in this problem is just count out total number of OKs, like how many O's are there. Then do a for loop from 0 till 9 of I, J, K, L. This is a set. If any of them is X, we just continue out because we don't have to count it out. Then we just count out or just insert that if the SI, because S is storing out whether that number is valid or not, or it is a O or not. If it is O, insert that into the set, or insert all these digits into the set. If the number of different digits, because that set is consisting of different digits, is equal to OK, which is meaning that total number of zeros which are there, then it is a total, like we just increment a total because that's a valid pin. And in the end, we just print out answer. I hope you understand the logic and the code. Stay tuned for more videos. I'll see you next one. Till then, keep coding and bye.